New at 6 right now, there are big and they are popping up all over the metro area. We're talking about those 5G towers. Many times they show up in neighborhoods seemingly without warning. Michael Beda joins us from Aurora tonight, where one appeared just this week in a woman's front yard. And Michael, did she know it was coming?
No, Karen, she didn't, even though the city says they sent her a letter telling her that it might be coming. Now she's got this big post at the end of her driveway, and there's not a lot that she can do about it.
It is huge.
Maureen MacArthur noticed some workers in her front yard Monday, so she asked them what they were up to.
And they said that they were changing the light pole.
She went back to work thinking nothing of it. That light pole stood at the end of her driveway for years. But when she left her house again,
I came out and I looked and I had this.
It is a light pole, but it's also a small cell antenna used for 5G cell phone and internet service. And it's a lot different than the old post. For one, Maureen says it's much wider, which makes it difficult for her to get larger vehicles out of her driveway.
This thing is impeding what I want to do for a life.
She's upset and would like for it to be moved.
Even if they put it in the backyard, I'd be fine with that.
But the city of Aurora says that part of Maureen's property is in the right-of-way, defined as 7 to 11 feet from the gutter.
Go all the way
to the middle of the measurement is to the middle of that cement thing.
So that's approximately the middle right there.
Yeah.
Approximately.
Yeah,
we're at 9 feet, 2 inches.
Even the furthest point of the structure still landed at just over 10 feet, well within the right-of-way. Still, Maureen feels like her rights as a property owner have been violated, and she wants the tower gone. But she doesn't know if that will ever happen.
How do you fight a single person fighting a big company? I need help.
Now, the city did send me proof that that letter was mailed to Maureen's address acknowledging the installation of the tower. Maureen says she was planning on buying an RV like a lot of Americans, but now, because she can't park that RV on the street and she can't park it in her driveway because it won't fit anymore, she has to put those plans on hold. In Aurora, Michael Aveta, covering Colorado First.
Thank you, Michael.